Hey there, guys, it's Salus, and welcome back to Salus's Week of Pain, god damn you all. Welcome to Ratchet & Clank Q-Force. Known elsewhere in the world as Ratchet & Clank Full Frontal, Assault, you dirty bastards. Full Frontal Assault. This was part of the 10th anniversary celebration, and as you know, I'm a massive Ratchet & Clank fan. You kind of have to be if you've got them tattooed on you. And this was such a kick in the nuts for fans. Because they had options over at Insomniac. They thought, let's see, could we design a game with old characters and make it play like the early Ratchet & Clank games that everyone loved? No, let's make a shitty tower defense game because they're easy. Lo and behold, the birth of Q-Force. Its main feature, co-op. So, you get to choose your character at the start. You can play as either everyone's favourite little reject robot, Clank, Captain Quark for some reason. Not that anyone would want to play as Captain Quark. He is a letdown no matter what he's doing. But for the sake of this video, I'm going to be playing as the Lombax hero of many galaxies, Ratchet. And yes, you do have to launch the game after you've selected your character, because that's just the way this game works, apparently. The loading screens on this are an arse. And I'll show you why in a minute. As you can see, it's taking its sweet time loading. And to be fair, it's not even a big game, real. I'd say it's a bit bigger than Quest for Booty. And here we have the classic disguised loading screen, which looks awesome as usual. Ratchet's ship flying into the docking bay of the Phoenix 2. Captain Quark's signature ex-presidential battle cruiser. And one of the things that annoys me about this is you get the hover boots really early on. You don't have to work for them, they're just there. But you'll see why they're important. You always start the game with Gadgetron's finest work, the Omni Wrench. Still massively overpowered. I love it. But unlike other Ratchet & Clank games, you don't go from planet to planet using your ship. Oh, no. You have to go to the command module of the Phoenix 2. And you have a choice of three planets to start with. I don't know how far it goes because, quite frankly, I don't want to play this game any more than necessary. You've got this one, that one, and a locked one. All the planets are locked until you beat the one before it. But for the purpose of this video, and because it's the only one I've actually cleared so far, and probably the only one I'm going to clear at all, we're going to do the Gorgon Refinery, and I'll show you exactly why this game is so bad. Right, now this sequence, pay attention to it. Those drop pods get launched. Fine. Are there help in there? Fuck no! This is left entirely up to Ratchet. On his own, what a crock of shit. Which actually brings me to my first major complaint of this game. And I will show you shortly. Come on, loading screen. Yep, these do take forever. Another disguise loading screen. I love how the fact that Ratchet's ship changes design every time, but it still vaguely resembles Ratchet's ship. And that little intro there is just to show you who you're playing as. Because this does have co-op. And I've played this. This was basically tutorial level. And unfortunately, it has, let's just say, some issues. You can still smash some of the things in the environment to get bolts, but you may notice I currently have no guns. How do you get the guns? You know those drop pods that were launched from the ship? Well, turns out they contain a shitty puzzle lock. Doop. And doop. There we go, shitty puzzle lock solved. I get my first gun, which is the combustor. It's currently level 2, because that's the only level I took it up to. Because there are far more useful guns. Yeah, and instead of all the little sarcastic humorous bits or the conversation bits from previous Ratchet Clank games. Instead, you've just got Ratchet blatantly telling you what to do. So yeah, these cables lead to the keynotes. We need to save the keynotes.
Power cables run to the
keynotes. Now, I've learned from playing this twice, because I had some problems recording this the first time, and indeed the second time, that it's best to get a load of bolts early. Because you don't really get the additional dropships for the enemies until you acquire a weapon. Yes, upgrading defenses is important, Ratchet, but right now gathering bolts to do so is more important. Now, the combustor, which is the first gun you get, is great against these little guys. However, he's utterly useless when faced with those big guys with space helmets. They are much easier defeated with the gun you get later on. And you will get it because you have to in order to progress. Hopefully these have some combustor ammo. Yes, they do. 50 combustor ammo. Right, let's just blow the shit out of that guy. Yeah, right, that's him done. And like I said, it's important to gather as many bolts as you can early on. And can I just say this? All the missions are like this. All of them. I first played this back in 2011. I think it was at EGX, actually, in Earl's Court. Before it moved to Birmingham, the far better venue. Not just geographically, but technically. And I was disappointed then with what this had to offer. Answer, not a fat lot. Because... Oh, that is a big drop pod. There are some in the levels. Basically, that's where you get your big scary weapons. But I don't want to do that. Like I said, we're gathering bolts and we're going to bolster the defences of the Q-Force base. Because as soon as I get another gun, we're going to start getting invasions. Your goal is to protect the generators at the Q-Force base. Right, that's heavily defended. We don't want to go that way. We want to go this way. And shoot the shite out of everything. Yep, you've lost your helmet. Sucks to be you. And you've lost your everything. Sucks to be you too. To be fair, it sucks to be you too anyway.
This one's mine.
I don't know about you, but I wouldn't want to be bothered. But yeah, this is basically how the game plays out in general. You kill a bunch of things, you collect a bunch of bolts, you upgrade your base defences, because it's all about the base. Like I said, this is a tower defence game. Poorly disguised as a Ratchet and Clank game, but it is a tower defence game. It's all about the TDs. I'm just going to rocket boot away from him. This is what I mean by having the hover boot really early on is a bad idea, because not only can you outrun most enemies using it, but if you do get invaded, there's no real pressure because you can get back to your base so easily. The maps are so small. But the whole idea of having something to defend is kind of pointless because you're kind of already there. It feels like you haven't gone anywhere. Alright, I'm going to take on this turret. Might be a stupid idea, but... Nope, I got him. Yeah. Every enemy basically has one weapon they're extremely weak to, and one weapon they're resistant to. And it's your job to decipher which is which. Yep, they're all down. They are now. And I'm currently sat on about 5,000 bolts. I want more. Always more bolts. Because the weapons in this are free. That's really annoying to me. As someone who played like the old Ratchet and Clanks, where you have to go to a Gadgeton vendor and buy your weapon. Now Captain Quark just gives them you for free. And to be honest, that is a massively annoying thing. The whole point of Ratchet and Clank was it's built on its economy. I mean, just to get the Rhino in Ratchet and Clank 1, you needed something like 50 million bolts, and that was ridiculous. Trying to keep him at a safe distance. There we go. Lovely. Right, now I've got enough bolts to go back to the base. It's time to put some defences in, because this is a tower defence. These are your towers, your generators. They power your Q-Force base. How? I don't know, I just assume magic. But apparently they're fueled by nanotech, which is the same stuff Ratchet uses for life. So maybe they're just burning life force. I don't know. So we're going to place the only turret we have, the pyro turret. Whatever they want to call it. It is called the pyro turret, I was right. And at the moment, if I unlock one weapon pod, we should only get the small fries, which should be easily handled by this. Double up on those. Then we're going to go and do another shitty puzzle, get another weapon.
Pyro turret acquired.
Yeah, a lot of the elements of Ratchet and Clank are here. Like the idea of having multiple paths to go down and... But unlike the Ratchet Clank ethos of different path means different like story or different thing, in Q-Force it's just different path means a different path for enemies to invade from. Now, I can buy either the Pyro Blaster, which is now an Alpha Pyro Blaster, the Cryo Shot, or the Doppelbanger. It's important to buy the Alpha Pyro Blaster first. Why? Because... Now, I will say this. Because this was a tutorial, you're not seeing this because I've gone back to it, but there were a lot of cutscenes, unskippable cutscenes. Every time an enemy dropship came, there was a cutscene. Every time the game had something to tutorialize, there was a cutscene. So it was very, very, very cutscene intensive. Also, whenever you pick up a new weapon, it automatically switches you to that weapon, and I don't want to use it on small fries. It's a good job these things drop bolts, because there's only a limited quantity of bolts available on the level. Also, you get a checkpoint every time you defend the base. No, not good. So, you've got to get a checkpoint in this, you have to wait until your base gets invaded, then fend off the invasion, and I've got to pay attention to these puzzles, because I keep failing at them horribly. There we go. Right, next, we're going to get the cryo shot, because... That's what the turrets are weak against. Now, we go back to the base. Again.
Oh, man.
And then, we want to start placing turrets again. But we can't. I've got to defeat more enemies. Or find hidden crates. And they will be hidden crates at this point. Right, here's why you get the Pyro Blaster. These things are incredibly weak to fire. Which doesn't explain why the combustor is so pathetic against them, because technically a combustor is fire. I mean, strictly speaking, that should be fire incarnate, but there we are. Now, there's another wave of enemies coming, so of course you've got to wait. Oh, they've been joined by a second wave. Are they coming from this side? No! Are they coming from this side? Who the hell cares? They are miles away, according to this. Yeah, your mini-map is kind of useless, but you get this little invasion meter on the right-hand side, which just tells you how far away they are from your base. It doesn't tell you where they are, what lane they're in, because I honestly think what they've tried to do here is cross a tower defense with a MOBA. So you've got the lanes of MOBAs, you've got... You've got the lanes of MOBAs, you've got the defense mechanisms of tower defense. It's all a load of crap. Right, freeze you.
Oh boy, not a good time to run out of ammo.
There we go. My cryo shot is level 2, right. Now, one thing you can do is when your base gets attacked, you can just spend bolts to repair your turret. I mean, it doesn't really matter, does it? It's only, like, that one thing. But bolts are so scarce in this that you have to kind of measure it up. Do I want defenses or do I want...
All generators are online.
Yes, you've told us that before, Ratchet. The power nodes are powered by cables. Yes, I was doing that when you told me to do that. God, pain in the ass. Like I said, a lot of the humour has been lost in this and it's just boiled down to a really bland experience. And that is... That is a massive pain for the fandom because... They have to bear with the fact that They basically decided to consult us. Right. Yes, unlock more weapon pods. Don't need to. Because the cryo shot takes care of those. But let's go exploring anyway. Because I can see a weapon thing up there. These are best dealt with lots of fire!
This keynote is heavily guarded. Recommend unlocking more weapon pods before.
Yeah, attacking. Once you get enough weapons, they start like dropping in like reinforcement waves. But at the moment, it should just be the small guys, so I don't need to worry too much about that.
Enemy reinforcements.
But we're gonna go and find a way to get that weapon pod up there. First, smash the trees, get the bolts. Bolts are life in this game. Well, nanotech is life, but... No, Ratchet, you can't beat the Omni-Wrench, because the Omni-Wrench is an Omni-Wrench. It's kind of in the name. It is designed to do everything. But you'll see why that is a nightmare later. Because they've taken out one of the key functions of the Omni-Wrench. I mean, you've seen most of them. But I bet there's one you've all forgotten. But I haven't forgotten. And I will not forgive either. Right, I've still got my fire gun on. Yep. Because they're bound to spring off about now. There we go. Lots of things to kill with fire. Kill it with fire. All of it with fire. And smashy, smashy. There we go. Yes, Ratchet, that's exactly what we're going to do. Get more defenses. That's the point of this. It is a tower defense, not a tower boring. Well, it's that too, but we'll leave that aside. Now, whenever you unlock one of these weapon pods, I'll show you in a minute. Boop, bloop.
Sweet.
Boop, bloop, bloop. Maybe you don't even have to be accurate. You don't have to aim for the thing. Right, I'm going to hit the doppelbanger. That gets me pyroblaster charges. And, oh, I need nanotech. Yeah, there we go. Nanotech automatically refills your health completely. That's not how it works. It should fill some of your health, not all. Some I can agree with, all not so much.
Enemy dropship now on approach.
Right, now I want to put a mine down, because you can basically your own defense are turrets or mines. The cryo mine just slows them down. It's not a great use of the term mine, or indeed the word cryo. Yeah, cryo mine. Watch it in action. Just slows them all down, and then they'll come into range of my turrets and get roasted alive. Lovely, 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 jubbly. Whereas these guys did not get slowed down all that much, but they are incredibly weak to fire, so a fire turret is ideal.
The Q-Force base is under attack.
And lo and behold, all I've got to do is take down this one big guy. Look, fortunately I have fire. Yeah, we've secured the Q-Force base again. I think I should really put the cryo mines here. That way they've already gone through the turrets. I don't even know why I care so much about this game. It is dull. But yeah, every time you unlock a weapon pod, you get that teleporter thing, which takes you straight back to your base. Okay, fine. But where's the threat exactly? Now, this cryo blaster is great against those. It instantly freezes them, and then you can just smash them with a wrench. Like so. And before that turret has time to aim, we dodge behind a rock. You don't even have to be particularly accurate with that one. That gun is just massively powerful.
Proceed with caution.
Now, I know there's one more, like, weapon pod somewhere, but I can't remember where it is, and I don't really care, because the only weapon I've got left is fairly useless at the moment. Alright, just freeze those. Smashy, smashy. And then all you gotta do is smash these generators down. Force field goes down. Now, this is probably one of the more challenging bits, because some of this terrain is destructible, so you can't rely on it for cover. Smashy, smashy. Enemy and down. Smashy smashy. And there we go. Right, fire gun for him. Sorry, did someone order a barbecue? Yep, these guys are brutal, but we have a cryo gun. We have a freeze ray. And they stay frozen for a good long while, I might add. So you can do exactly what I just did. Freeze all four of them and leave them to it.
These guys are brutal.
Now we just smash the generator. You just use your wrench for this. The tutorial says to use your gun because it puts one deliberately out of wrenching range. But do you remember when I said that took one of the features out, the Omni wrench? Observe. Why is this not a bolt?
Nice.
The whole point was Ratchet used his Gadgetron Omni wrench in order to turn giant bolts, which are switches. And smash. The story as well is a bit lackluster. Basically, Captain Quark is bored since he lost the election to become president of the universe. And basically got fired.
The planetary defense center is now accessible.
And suddenly someone threatens the galaxy. He takes over three planets, which are the ones you have to defend your bases on. And yeah, that's pretty much the whole gist of it. Turns out, though, later on, after you complete this tutorial, that the person who's doing this was originally part of the Captain Quark fan club. Yeah, it's that kind of story. Basically, all he says is, I'm someone who Captain Quark let down, blah, blah, blah. And, yeah. I mean, like I said, I haven't actually finished this game, but I've heard it's slightly longer than Quest for Booty, but I can't, like, guarantee that. Ooh, a Golden Bolt, that's always a standard, but they were a lot harder to get to before. And smashy, smashy. Right, that's got to be some more bolts. Time to do some more base upgrading, I think. Yeah, I think not, mate. Right, it's zippity-doo-dah out here. Because there's two more things I've got to get. I've got to get another one of these weapon pods that'll trigger another event.
A gold bolt.
I've already got that one. Where did I see one? I know there is one because I've got to collect the thingamajigger. There it is. Right, collect my thingamajigger and then we're going to go and get the big thingamajigger. The only thing I've got left is this one, the Thunder Smack. You'll see what that does eventually. Right, so if I select Let Thunder Smack and aim it there, all it does is create a small electrical field which will electrocute anything in range. That is it. Enemies are approaching the base, you say? Look at that, full health. I was low on health, but full health and one bloody nanotech crate. The hell? Right, fire gun. Burn them all away.
I found it.
Warning, enemies are approaching the base.
Yeah, so far I haven't actually found a decent use for the Thunder Smack. It's just been a case of I've got it. I suppose in later levels there might be enemies that are weaker to lightning, but right, spend the bolts. Right, we're gonna need turrets everywhere, I think. Purchase turret. Yes, I know it's still occupied by Grungarian forces. Not gonna mine there.
See ya.
And finally, the other mine. Got to replace these every time. There is a cooldown on these nodes, so you can't place a mine as soon as it's been destroyed. And also, they don't seem to take anything out on your turrets either.
Please rectify.
So let's just sail through here. We'll take the shortcut. Whee! Actually, no. We were going for the big weapon, weren't we? The big smashy weapon. Oh, you survived my Thunder Smack. Okay, fair enough. So did you,
nice.
You bastard.
Ammo.
Right, to get the big smashy weapon, it involves the only adherence to the whole Ratchet and Clank thing this game actually does, which is it has some platforming. Emphasis on the word some. Not a fat lot, if I'm entirely honest. Because Ratchet and Clank for me has always been, it's a platformer with action bits and a cool story and interesting characters. And Q-Force has just stripped all of that away. Probably because it's only called Q-Force in, I think it's Europe. It might only be the UK. But I think they were just hoping that the original name, Full Frontal Assault, would get people excited. Right, I can either choose the Plasma Bomb Launcher or my Warmonger, which is basically the missile launcher. Now, I did with the Warmonger in my last record, so I'm going to try this, the Plasma Bomb Launcher. Right, now I'm going to go and defend my base one last time. Because this is basically the every level is like this. You build up your base, you set your defenses, every time you get something, a wave of enemies appear. You unlock the key nodes, there might be more than one, but there's only one on this level, so I'm kind of happy, it's nice and short. Then you go and activate the defense center, and then you've got a bit at the end, which I will show you soon. Die. Die, all of you. Right, for this bit, I'm going to need the cryo shot again, because there's two cannons here. Cryo shot ready. Cannon freeze, cannon freeze. I said cannon freeze. Thank you. Yeehaw! Right, Ratchet, what? Yeah, this is just... The humour's gone. The characterisation has gone. And like I said, my biggest complaint with this is I'm playing as Ratchet alone. Where's Clank in all this?
10 bad guys down.
It's gotta be, oh, we're hoping for co-op with the Clank thing. Can I point out this game is called, the game series is called Ratchet and Clank, not Ratchet or Clank. Very, very different games. I mean, I realise there have been some where they've been separated, like Ratchet Clank Size Matters on the old PSP.
Just can't beat the old army.
And Clank's had his own missions in like Ratchet and Clank 1 when he's going to explore outside the ship because he doesn't need oxygen. But this is a whole game where they're separated. And yes, there's the whole cracking time thing. Don't remind me of that. You don't need to. Right. Just a bog standard blaster gun. Blasty, blasty, blast away.
Got him.
Switch to the fire gun. Fire, your only weakness. And burn them to death. The guns are just ridiculous in this. So once you know which one does what and which enemies are weak to which, you kind of already reached a state of openness. Now, you think, up there, that's the boss. Right, let's see how you like a plasma bomb launcher. Oh, I didn't show you what the doppelbanger does. It does this. I forgot about the turrets. Right, take them down. Like I said, once you free something, it takes one shot to kill it with whatever gun. It's easier just to double shoot them with a cryo shot. I wonder how powerful the cryo shot is against that thing. Not at all, it doesn't freeze. Because it's mega. So we're going to go back to the plasma bomb launcher and hopefully we're going
to
get some decent hits off. You never know, I might die here just to show you what happens. See, I'm at a distance now where it doesn't even realise I'm there, but I can still take massive amounts of its health off. Let's just chuck in the old Thunder Smack. Am I hit it right in the head with a Thunder Smack? No, of course not. But I can do massive amounts of damage to it when it's not even shooting me. I'm right in front of it. Doing handstands.
I'm out!
Right, now I'm deliberately going to die because I'm going to show you something really annoying. When you die normally, the game will respawn all enemies. I'm right underneath it, doesn't even know I'm here. What the hell? But anyway, as I was saying, normally when you die, the game will respawn all of the enemies. But when you die to this guy, it sets a checkpoint arbitrarily just before the jumpy bit, just before the platforming. And the long and short of it is, no enemies respawn, and he has all of his health. He has all the health you removed still removed. So all the damage you've done to him remains, thus making that fight incredibly easy. Alright, just blow those up. I better smash that from a wrench because, you know, I'm angry about this. This is just hurting the fandom. Now, do you know those shitty pulls you have to do to unlock the weapons? They shouldn't be on the weapon pods, they should be here. But no, what do you get? One button activates the defense field. If you had to do a puzzle similar to what the infiltrator or the hacker did, that'd be great, because that's Ratchet and Clank. But this isn't. Where's the wall jumping? Where's the swing shot? Where's all the cool gadgets? Captain Quark is standing there like a jackass, like usual. And before I go ahead and activate the reboot sequence, I'm just going to pick up all of the ammo in the universe. Because that's kind of vital right now. Yep, we're going to place another fire turret. Because we can. And then purchase a mine, and you. Yeah, every generator can have one turret and one mine, which is a bit stupid, really. It should be able to just have two turrets and then have the mines as free placements. Because these positions here are fairly useless. I mean, I can see why they're here. But no, just no. Right, I've got no more nanotech around upstairs, so I'm going to take this one for now. That gets me full health for the oncoming onslaught. This is the end of the level. What you have to do is you have to activate this piece of crap. And then while the defense center is rebooting, everyone just invades.
Yes.
And it's not so good. You can still place your defenses while the assault's going on, but it does eat up valuable time. And that's basically what tower defense runs on, time.
Warning, major assault in progress.
So now we just have to wait for them to attack, like a patient little child. And yeah, it'll give you the computer, the most boring computer in the universe. I mean, the computer on board the Phoenix 2 has an amazing personality. It's basically stoned. If I was going to use any word in the universe, I would use stoned. It sounds like a stoned surfer dude.
25% complete. The Q Force base.
Yeah, there's the cooldown, and I haven't learned a false. Screw it. Right, have to wait till the next wave. And here we are. Here's the next wave. Slowed by the cryo mines. Thrown straight into my flame turrets. Now I just run in and burnerize them. La di da da. Not much of a challenge because I know full well the ammo at the base always resupplies quite frequently. So you can run through, make sure the other side is safe, and just pick up ammo as you go.
He's down.
Yeah, burn all of you. Now, do I have enough for another cryo mine? Yes. Lovely. In fact, I have enough for another one over here as well. Right, burnerize you. Yep, 90%. I just leveled up my Alpha Pyroblaster. Lovely. Yeah, the leveling up in this game is really quick as well. I mean, you've always been able to level up your weapons. That's been kind of a Ratchet Clank standard for a good long while. But it always used to take some time. In this, it practically takes no time at all. Hilariously fast. And the only reason I can think for that is it's actually a very short game. And this is supposed to be their big 10th anniversary celebration. Not celebrating it in the best possible manner, are we? Yeah, burn all of you. And then come over here, and there's another one of these bloody things. Right, throw my doppelbanger in. Throw my thingy in. And then start hitting it with plasma mines, because I'm a dick.
Got it.
Gotta love plasma grenades. And then, back to Mr. Shooty. Oh, damn it. How is that destroyed? Oh, it's over the other side. Okay, so I was busy fighting the big guy. My turrets couldn't even handle these. Right, I'm just going to burn their faces off. Burn all of you. There we go. And that's the end of it.
Not a good time to run out of ammo.
Lo and behold. And that is all you do all game. There's a few little character moments in the cutscenes, but other than that, nothing else really happens in this. It is just defending the towers. Not so cool. Salus no likey. And I'm saying that from the point of view of someone who likes Ratchet and Clank. I freaking love Ratchet and Clank, they're great. But this is Ratchet or Clank. In fact, I'd say that's the same problem for me as Ratchet and Clank All for One.
Where is now secure.
You got to play as Ratchet or Clank or Captain Quark or Dr. Nefarious, all these classic characters, but it was always one or the other. And that was the worst part of it. And the only reason I think they made a tower defense game is because, and I've been told this, I am not parroting anyone, because they're easy to make. Because you don't need to program enemy AI, you just set them on a path and let them do as they will. So, it is a massive kick in the fandom for anyone who enjoys this series. This game is pain personified. So, thank you all for watching Salus's Week of Pain Day 2. I've been Salus. They have not been Ratchet and Clank. And I will see you next time.